For me, the only downside to perfect roast dinner is the fight about who washes up afterwards. So Meg and I are going to avoid that by cooking everything in one roasting tin, starting with the spinach and mushroom stuffing.
A little bit of salt and pepper, please. Good girl.
In with the garlic and the mushrooms.
To toss the pan, you push down and pull back.
Oh, gosh.
Down and push back. Off you go. Take your time. Push it down. And then flip it back. Good. That's it. Push down. Nice.
Oh, I'm going to drop it soon.
We're going to sort of make a little well. A little touch of butter in the middle. Now, I want you to start putting the spinach in the middle, please. So you can push that down. The spinach is cold, so you're not going to burn yourself. Toss it, and you'll see it wilting and disintegrating away. Put this all on your board now. Now, outside and come in gently. Good. Regroup. And take your time. Good. Right.
Oh, I love that smell.
What is that?
Lemon thyme.
Lemon thyme, that's right. So you get your little thyme stalks and you pull them down, you sort of strip lemon thyme in. Now, tarragon. Roughly chop the tarragon. A nice sprinkling of fresh breadcrumbs. Next, we're gonna get an egg yolk. Now with the beef, this is the exciting part. Slice with the bone, and then come inside and go two-thirds of the way down. Hold that open for Daddy. Salt and pepper. And then look, we pack our stuffing in there. This.
Amazing.
It's incredible. Now, just gently hold that there like that.
Tying string around the rib will keep it all together during roasting.
Not too tight. If we tie it too tightly, what happens?
The stuffing will come out.
That's right. That's ready for roasting. But we're going to protect it and sit it on a trivet.
If you want to enjoy these delicious roast vegetables at their best, make sure you remove them from the hot oven after 35 minutes and reheat before serving with your beef.
Now, a little mix for the top. A couple of teaspoons of mustard powder in salt, a couple of tablespoons of olive oil. Mix that in. So this forms a really nice glaze.
My one-pot roast dinner goes into a hot oven 15 minutes at 230 degrees, then down to 170 degrees for another 2 hours.
Beautiful.
For a delicious twist on traditional Yorkshire puds, I'm going to lace mine with fresh horseradish. Start with plain white flour in a bowl and crack in the eggs. Adding only half of your milk at this stage makes it much easier to whisk all the lumps out. And if, like me, you like your puddings a little lighter and crispier, add a dribble of cold water and add salt to season. When you're happy, your batter is lump-free, whisk in the remaining milk. Peel and grate horseradish and add a handful to the mix. We can leave the batter to rest while we get the meat from the oven.
That is beautiful. And this is where you really need to let it rest.
How long would you say to rest it for?
I like to rest the meat for at least 20 minutes.
Just the right amount of time for us to whack up the oven and to get our Yorkshire puddings in. I love using the rich dripping, but vegetable oil is a healthier option. To get the fluffiest Yorkshires, your tray and fat must be piping hot. For best results, take your jug of batter to the oven and pour the mixture in there. It takes just 15 minutes for our Yorkshire puds to puff themselves up and turn a delicious golden brown. And the beef is ready to serve up.
Lift that up, place that onto the board. Parsnips, carrots, one beautiful big slice. And then on the side.
The stuffing.
The stuffing, the bit that's
the best
to die for. Now, fantastic Yorkshire
style. They're amazing.
Aren't they beautiful?
Mm-hmm.
That's for you, my darling. And that one, that's for me. That beautiful roast beef with a twist. Wow.